Hi children, how are you? I hope everything is going fine. Take utmost care during this pandemic situation. Don't go out. Listen to your parents. Don't irritate them. Stay home, stay safe. Welcome to 6th class, first science video session. In this session, we are going to learn about the source of food. Children, observe the mind map of the lesson. In this mind map, see what is there in the first box, food. It is the basic requirement of life and its sources. So, plants and animals are two main sources of food. So, what do we get from plants? We get roots, leaves, stems, fruits, seeds, flowers. So, what do we get from plants? We get roots, leaves, stems, fruits, seeds, flowers. What do we get from animals? Milk, meat, fish, egg, etc. According to food habitat, animals are divided into three types: herbivores, omnivores, carnivores. Animals that eat only plants are herbivores. Animals that eat only animals are carnivores. Animals that eat both plants and animals are omnivores. Next, let us learn about the need for food. All living organisms need food to survive. Without food, can we live? No, not only human beings and animals, every living organisms need food for living. That means food is essential for both animals and plants. What happens if we do not take sufficient food? We feel exhausted and weak. If we do not eat properly, what happens if we do not take sufficient food? We feel exhausted and weak if we do not eat properly for few days. We cannot live without food for more than few days. So, let us see the function of food. First one, it provides energy to do work and other activities. Second one, it helps in growth of our body. Third one, it helps in the healing injuries and protect our body from diseases. Fourth one, it keeps our body warm. Let us start the source of food. Plants and animals are two main sources of food. We get food from plants in the form of roots, stems, leaves, flowers, fruits. All green plants are called producers as they produce their own food. Animals are unable to make their own food as the plants do, and they depend on plants and other sources for food. So they are called consumers. Food from plants. Green plants prepare their food using light and carbon dioxide from air, water and chlorophyll. They prepare more food than they need. The extra food is stored in different parts of the plant, and the extra food is the food that we consume. Food that comes from different parts of the body of plants are roots. Roots in some plants store food. These food laden roots get modified into food that we can eat. Some examples are carrot, radish, turnip, sweet potato. Stems. Some plants store food in their stems. Example, sugarcane, potato. In some plants, laden stems get swollen, modified into different shapes. These stems are located under the ground. We call these stems as underground modified stems. Example, ginger and turmeric. Next, leaves. Do you like leafy vegetables? I think everyone say no. But leafy vegetables are very healthy food which gives us large amount of vitamins that helps us to be healthy. Leaves are widely used as a part of our food. Leaves from lettuce are eaten as solid. Example, cabbage, spinach, fenugreek. You know, mean fenugreek and a menthol to chetundi akuni menthi akantam fenugreek are used as vegetables. Leaves from mint and coriander are used condiments. Condiments means flavor. So if you observe your parents cooking, you can see coriander is used as final topping in the every item they cook, because it has great flavor and also good for health, and even they are used in medicinal purpose. Freshly food laid leaves on the bulbs of onion and garlic are widely in different varieties of food items. Now we discuss about the flowers. Flowers from certain plants like cauliflower, banana, etc. are used as vegetables. Sweet smelling soft and rosy petals from rose are used for preparing jam, gulkanda, which is taken as mouth freshener and also medicine.